He's on the buses and the airplanes.
Hi, my name's Amanda Easton. I'm a performer, singer-songwriter from Sydney, Australia. I make retro-inspired, theatrical, electronic pop. But when I'm not doing my own music, I do
cabaret,
cover band gigs, solo gigs, tribute shows, recording sessions. Welcome to my Circle of Light vlog.
And I've been watching you from me.
Hi, how are you? Good evening. It's evening here in Sydney, Australia. I've actually got to apologise because I'm a few minutes late. Let's call it fashionably late, rock and roll late. Actually, you wouldn't believe it. I did a couple of gigs at the Opera House, which in itself is amazing. But I was co-producer of the shows and they said, no, we don't start on time. We start 10 minutes past. I'm like, even the Opera House is rock and roll and starts a little bit late. So I don't feel so bad. I'm sorry I'm a little bit late. I do like to be on time. I hope you've had a nice week. I always say that on a Thursday night because it feels like it's starting to, you know, come down into the weekend. And weekends are very different nowadays because it used to be ramping up to the weekend with all the gigs, and now it's, you know, ramping up to see some Spider-Man films on the couch. Having said that, it feels like things are starting to come back to normal for me, and I am excited, but it's really hard to feel 100% happy when you see the state of the world. And if you're not in Australia or New Zealand, who I guess seem to be doing the best so far, please stay safe and well, and I hope you're doing okay. I did get a gig today, which was very exciting. You know, in the old days, I used to do 4 or 5 gigs a week, and while I always appreciated them, I think, I didn't get super excited when the phone rang, when it was a standard gig, but the phone rang and it was a standard gig. I'm like, yes, yes, please, yes, I'm very excited. Proper pay and everything, because there has been a lot of cases of people offering pretty rubbish money. And, you know, everyone's hurting to a certain extent financially, but artists really are hurting. So to pay us, you know, ridiculous money, it's not on. So it feels like, because things are doing so well in Australia, I don't want to be too hopeful because, you know, anything can change overnight, but things feel like they're getting back to normal. I actually go out into the street and, you know, talk to people at a distance. We still don't go to any shops. We get everything delivered and we're not getting takeaway and all that kind of stuff, but I'm going to have a live stream that I've spoken about, not a little one like this, but a proper big concert with the First Ladies of Soul on July 3rd. And that will entail me getting out of the house and being face to face with a few people. And I'm really, really excited about that because the First Ladies of Soul is a really fun band to do. And that's with Liza Olbach and Jo Elms up the front. And we've got Kimmy Tapai on the drums, Victor Rounds on the bass, Joe Macri on the keys, and Eric Rasmussen on guitar, and all those guys sing as well. So what a lineup, huh? And that's part of the Dan Fabian Productions live stream that they do. You might have seen a couple of them over the last weeks, really high quality live streams, and they're no ticketing as such, so if you feel like tipping you can, but no obligation. And that's July the 3rd on a Friday night. There'll be a YouTube link that you follow and see live, and I'll send that out as it gets a little bit closer. But there's also a real gig, not that that's not a real gig, but it's not really a real gig. The week after, I'm doing a duo with Jo Elms, who I just mentioned. First Ladies of Soul is her show. And we have a duo called Dance Little Sister. And we didn't do that many gigs because we had so much other things happening with the shows that we did together and separately. But we've kind of reinvigorated it now because there's more work for duos and solos than anything else at the moment. And so I'm doing a gig with her at Penrith Panthers in the Birdcage, which is very appropriate because the social distancing will be built in, because if you've ever been there, it's beautiful. The stage is actually in this ornate cage. It's actually like a birdcage. It's all very Great Gatsby themed, and it's actually a really lovely spot. So I'm really looking forward to working with her on Friday the 10th. And what else is happening? We're doing... I have a Fleetwood Mac tribute show called Rumours, and it's a 7-piece band. And a lot of the venues can't, one, afford or have the space to fit us in quite yet, although I hope that'll change soon. But so we're doing a mini Mac, and we often call our show Big Mac. So I've been calling this one Junior Burger, which is really not very appealing. It's not going to make people want to come and see us, but that's just my private name for it. So that'll be like Rumours Unplugged, which I'm also excited about. And that'll be later in July. I think it's the 17th at the Brass Monkey. So there'll be two shows in a night so that they can fit more people in over a time frame of like two different seatings, which I think is a clever way of going about it. So how exciting! Actual gigs! Woohoo! I am happy. And funnily enough, you know, at this stage, even though I know it's not over and I know, you know, there could be a spike in cases and we still all have to be careful, it does feel like it's a little bit at the end of a period. It's at the end of, you know, the really big isolation and all the fear and the shock and everything that happened in the beginning. And looking back, I feel like, I mean, I've actually enjoyed myself a lot of the time. And, you know, that's not to discount the suffering that people have gone through, because that's always in the back of my mind. And you can't really say, oh, this is fantastic, I'm having a great time, when the world is in a terrible shape. But personally, I've had fun creating different things and hanging out with the family more than ever. And I think of all the things I've learnt. I used to do a lot of these kind of Facebook things where I just have a chat, because having a chat comes pretty naturally to me, and, you know, I'll talk the leg off a chair. And I don't get nervous about having a chat, but weirdly, I get nervous about sitting here and playing the piano and singing when you're just there and I don't have the wonderful musicians around me that I generally work with, and I don't have the sound engineer and the gear and the everything else. And it's really quite confronting to sit here and play and sing to you. And I only did it a couple of months ago for the first time. And now it's just, you know, not that I don't still get a little bit nervous, but it's just part of what I'm used to now. It's part of my life. Weird how things can change, and even the technology around it I'm starting to get. And my live stream last week, I did a song, and somebody was listening in, or they saw it afterwards, and I got invited to go on a new streaming platform called Sessions. I'm not sure how long it's been around, but if you remember Pandora, which is it's a music mapping program. So it's before Spotify ever did this, Pandora existed, and you could type in, like for me, one of my favorite bands in the world is Goldfrapp. So I type in Goldfrapp and Pandora would choose a whole lot of Goldfrapp songs, but also artists and songs that sounded like Goldfrapp. Now, I'm not sure how Spotify do it. I have a feeling they do it like with an algorithm or kind of a computerized matching, but Pandora, I'm pretty sure, did it. They actually mapped the songs, a lot of it by listening. It was a lot more manual. And it was the most amazing thing, Pandora. And anyway, the one of the guys that started Pandora has started this Sessions thing and sent me an email and said, you want to come on this platform and give it a go? And I'm sure, you know, he's asked 1,000 other people as well, but wow, yes, thank you. So they're actually they're offering some payment to appear on this dedicated live streaming platform, which is a tipping thing as well, so people are encouraged to tip, or you can just come along and have a look, and just have a look for nothing if you want as well. But I did my first one, and I didn't tell anybody about it, just in case I was rubbish and, you know, it didn't work out, whatever. But I did my first one today at 1 o'clock, and the deal was you had to stay on at least 20 minutes, but I was having a ball, and I ended up staying on for over an hour, and I think between 500 and 700 people were watching, which is amazing. And so, you know, I'll keep you updated and let you know how it goes. But it's always hard to choose a time to do these Facebook Lives, because I have obviously local friends and then people in the UK and the US and Canada and Europe, and there's not really a time that suits everybody. And so what I thought I might do is continue doing these live streams, and a lot of people, most people I think, watch it afterwards, but to still have that live element is really nice. And I've got to say that I can't see your comments. The last couple of weeks I haven't been able to see anyone's comments. I wonder why. Because I love it when I can see who's there beforehand. No, I can't. So if I'm not saying hello to you, that's because I can't see the little heads haven't popped up. But I will say hello to you at the end, and I do appreciate you being here. But so the idea is I'll continue doing this one for those who are awake, and then I'll do one that makes more sense for people on the other side of the world, like in the US, through this sessions platform. If they asked me to come back, because I think it was almost like an audition today, so they wanted to see, you know, what I was like, and then if it worked out, they'll ask me back. I haven't heard from them yet, so let's hope. It felt like it went well, so I hope it did. It was fun. And this live streaming thing now, it's just kind of, I know everybody's saying the new normal, but it's becoming the new normal for a lot of artists. And I think live streaming has been around for a long time, really, but nobody bothered as much with it as they do now because we had so many other options. But with the less options, people started to focus on live streaming, and I think it'll just get incorporated into our normal world now. I hope, because I actually enjoy it. I'm, you know, slowly starting to get comfortable with it. Okay, what else is happening? There is, I think they used to call it International Music Day, but now they call it Make Music Day, or in Australia we call it Make Music Australia, at least. It's a day basically in the past where a whole lot more venues would open up, including kind of street spaces and busking type things as well, and everyone was encouraged to play music on this particular day. Apparently it started in the 80s in France, and it was called Fête de la Musique, but it was taken on by the rest of the world. And of course, with the way things are now, it's not about outdoors and venues at the moment, it's all about online. And so that's on Sunday, and so because it's online, it's about videos and all sorts of, you know, different kind of creative things that can be done online. And so I'm creating a video that I hope will work out that I'm going to post as part of this Make Music Australia Day on Sunday. So keep an eye out for lots of creative stuff coming from, it'll be like, you know, cabaret and magic and comedy and anything that involves music, but in all different kind of areas. So I'm looking forward to seeing what's out there. So it's a matter of looking out for the hashtag, and there's also a Make Music Australia website where there'll be a gallery of all different stuff. So that's pretty exciting. Lots of things happening. It's not just Star Wars and Spider-Man movies, so that's really good. So I got a request to play an Australian song, and there are a lot of choices. Obviously, there's a lot of Australian songs that I like, but this song isn't strictly Australian. So Mike, I hope you forgive me, but it was a massive hit in Australia, and it was actually originally a French song, I think. And the cover of it was done in English and in French by Wendy Matthews, who's actually Canadian. She's French-Canadian, but she lives here in Australia, and I think she's had most of her career in Australia. The most beautiful singer. I was very lucky to be her backing singer for a long time. And there's one particular song that she had that was a really big hit for her. And I'm sure you know, if you're Australian and you're watching this particularly, it was called The Day You Went Away. A really gorgeous ballad. Actually, I think the original was up-tempo, but she turned it into this beautiful ballad, and her voice on it is just so divine. And it's a song that I kind of grew up with. And so when I started doing backing vocals for her, and I'm singing the backing vocals on this song that I grew up with and meant something to me, that was just the most magical moment. The first time, every time I stepped on stage to do backing vocals for this particular song. And there was one night, we were at a venue on the Northern Beaches, and what happens in, there's usually a full band, but for this song it's just piano, and she, you know, had the most beautiful piano players. So it would be the piano player, Wendy singing, and me as the backing singer. And so the stage kind of cleared. You know, the rest of the guys left the stage. the audience suddenly all really focused in because everyone knows and loves this song, and it's a beautiful kind of melancholy, slow, gorgeous song. So you might even get people, you know, with their arms in the air and these beautiful looks on their faces. And this one particular time, I'm looking out into the audience, which I love to do to see how people are being moved by the music. And everyone was exactly that. They had, you know, these really serene, lost in the music kind of faces, and it was beautiful. And this one particular night, everybody had that look on their face except for one woman. There was one woman who seemed to be kind of in the middle of everybody, and she was literally like disco dancing. It's this beautiful, soft, melancholy ballad, and she's going crazy on the dance floor. And I caught the piano player's eyes, and we just had to look away because we couldn't be distracted from what we were doing. We didn't want to spoil it for everybody else. And she continued almost the entire time going crazy with the dance steps during this beautiful ballad. And I remember I wrote a note, you know, in my kind of songwriting journal that I always keep with me. She was dancing to the music in her head. And I ended up writing a song called Dance to the Music in Your Head, which I will play after this, but first I'm going to play you nowhere near as well as Wendy and her piano player did it, but I want to play you this song because I love it. And I think, Mike, that it kind of is an Australian song because it was such a big hit here, so I hope you enjoy it.
Would rain the day you went away.
a cat on the keyboard now. I don't know if you can see her. Smokey, I can't see the music. Camera, Smokey. Oh, how cute is my pussy cat, huh? You can purr into the microphone. It's such a lovely sound. Oh, you just sit down for it. I've got one more song and then I'll come and play. All right. Never work with kids or animals. Okay, thank you so much for joining me tonight. Star of the show, Miss Smokey Skywalker over here. So I thought I would play the song that song indirectly inspired. You know, this woman dancing like crazy in the middle of the ballad made me think, what's going on in her head that she can let this beautiful song just go by her and dance so frantically and crazily? Something that just didn't have anything to do with what was happening all around her. And I'm sure we all have had moments where we live in our own head because what's going on outside is a little bit too hard to bear. And so I guess the song is about a time when it was a little bit too hard to bear for me, the outside world, but it did, the inspiration for it is kind of funny, but it's not a funny song. Okay, Smokey, you just stay right there, okay? You can dance down there. Yeah, good girl.
To my deepest blue.
hold up there to your throat. You swear under your breath you'll never sink down to this depth. Oh, yeah, oh, no, oh, whoa.
By Smokey Skywalker. Thank you so much for joining me tonight. I hope you have a wonderful rest of the week, and I'll see you next week. See you later.